Welcome to ScriptCase, the complete low-code platform that empowers developers to create dynamic and customized web applications with speed and efficiency. In this tutorial, I'm going to introduce the SC Send Notification macro, which is an essential tool in ScriptCase's notification model. The SC Send Notification macro makes easier than ever for developers to create and send notifications directly from their applications, keeping users up to date with important messages, alerts, or system events. So let's see here within this example how it works. I'm going to log here as admin. We have already applied here the notification model along with the security. Okay, there is a video explaining the step-by-step for creating the notification model. You can find the link here within the description. So in this case here, we have the admin user, okay, and we have the notification options and the security applications. So you have the user list, then you have also the groups. And we have two groups here. If we want to send a notification, we are going to use here this interface. So let's run a test here. Then you have the recipient. You can choose all, profile or custom. So profile, you have to set the profiles. You have here the option and the application to add a new profile. You can add here the profiles, adding users or groups, one or more than one group, or one or more than one user as well. Okay, so you will save the group and then you'll be able to use here the group, or you can create, it's like you create the profile in runtime. So you can use the custom, then here you can apply one or more groups and also the profiles, the users. Okay, so those are the options. Let's choose here the option all just for this test, and I will set here the date, send notification. So this is how I'm going to send a normal notification using the notification the notification system. So we can see here the notification arrived. So we have here the test. Let's clean here the ones we've receive it, okay, delete. And now let's test with the macro, okay? So I did here one example, imagining the scenario. Let's say we are here inside the login screen, and then we are a new user, and we have this application to add new users. I will copy and open in another window, okay? So I want to notify, for example, the admin every time a new user gets into the system. So I want the admin to get this notification automatically. So I am the admin here and I want to receive this notification. So let's test. I will go here and add a new user. Notification, then password, okay. Notification, okay. So those are the mandatory fields. I will add here and then jump to the other window to see the notification coming. So let's add here, okay. So we can see here the message, new user, and then user registered, okay, it's in Portuguese. And the macro is working, okay? Let's jump now to the development environment and we are going to see how to create this step by step. I'll start over creating again the notification, the security, so you can understand all the steps, okay? So let's go here to new project. Notification macro. Let's use the sample database. English, okay. Okay. So now we are going straight to a security model. I will create here super quickly. Create menu, okay. Login settings, okay. Email settings, we can add here one API. We have this one here available. So, Mandrill. Then users. We are also creating the default group. Authentication, we don't need. Okay. We are going to insert here the admin and the group admin. Okay. Generate security. We don't need to save the profile. It's not mandatory here in the security model. Generate source code. So now we have the applications. Let's run. So this is the new security. Admin. So here we have security. The user list is empty, just with admin. And we have this application to add the new user. This is the application we are going to play with. And let's now add the notification. Okay, notification. I have one here. I will create another one. Notification table. So everything is going to be filled here by security with the security information. Let's go next. Then we have the general settings, email settings. We can use the same as the security model. SMS, if you want also to notify by SMS. Insert applications, okay. Very easy and fast. Here we are going to add the profile name. This is mandatory. You need to add this name because it will be important for the macro. It will be necessary for the macro. Let's add here, for example, notification. Okay. Generate source code. And close. Okay. So notification is ready. Security is ready. So this is what Scriptcase creates automatically. No coding at all. So we have security and notification. I can send the notification again as a test, just to test the new model. All. Okay. So the notification system is working. And now we are going to make the test with the new user. So we have here the application, new user. The name of the application is APP Form ADD Users. So let's search this application inside the security. So here we have, we can also do something like this. And here is where we are going to program and use the macro. So first, let me get here the code from the macro. I'm going to create a function here inside programming, PHP methods. We have already the methods from this application created by the security model. The method will be called notification. Notification, okay. Then here I will apply the code, but commented, so we can see step by step. So first we have the macro SC send notification, accepts array of parameters to configure the notification. Okay, the first parameter is title. Let me put here in dark so it's better for us to read. So the first parameter is title. Title of the message defines the title of the notification message. Then we have here the message itself. We will type here the content of the notification message. This is the main body text that will be displayed in the notification. Then we have destiny type. Okay, destiny type is very important to understand. You have different types. You have user, you have group, you have all, and you have profile. So user will be if you need to send to a specific user or more than one user. Group, if you want to send to one or more groups. All, you will send to all the users. And profile, you will be using that profile from the recipients inside the notification, okay? And then you have the to. Once you define here the destination type, then you will specify within the chosen type the notification will be sent to. So here, for example, you set user, then it will inform which users. If you set group, it will inform which groups. All, you don't need to inform because it will be all. And the profile, you will need to add the name of the profile or profiles if it's more than one, okay? Then you have the from, who will be sending the notification. This can be the name or ID of the sender. You can use the variables from the security. If it's empty, the system will fill, will add automatically the name system, because since we have the notification being displayed inside the menu, you will need to have this from information, because then the system will expect for this information. And you have link, which is a link you want to add to the message. Date for the expiration. You can add here the date or not. It's not mandatory. And the format is date time, year, month, and day, then hour, minute, and second. And then you have the last one, profile. Then this last profile here is related to the profile you created when you create the notification model. So here we have, for example, this one, notification demo, is the profile we've just created. So this is the one you are going to use inside the profile parameter. So let me add here one example. I will add here a title, so let's translate here, new user. Then we have the message, user, then the user. Okay. And then we have the macro. So this is just to define here the title and the message. I wanted to concatenate here, it's just for organization. Then title, message, destiny type. So in this case, I'm going to use user, okay? Then the to, it will be the admin, and the from will be also admin. And then the link, I don't need the link for this case. Date for expiration, let's add here, for example, 5. And then profile name, we are going to use here this profile. Okay, so this is all I need to use the macro. Then I'll have to create here this function to finish the method. Okay, so now save, and I will call the method inside the event on after inset, because I want to receive this notification every time I have a new user inserted using this through this application. So I will call the macro, the method here after this command before the sc commit. Okay, so this is what I need. Save and run. Okay, so let's open this inside another window. And here, let's test again. This database is empty, so I can use the same. Let me run the login screen as admin. I will remove here this message. Okay. 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 New user and message. Marcia registered to the system. So this is an example of how you can use the macro. If you're new to Scriptcase, now is the time for you to explore everything the platform has to offer. Download and test for free and discover the power of the SSC notification macro along with many other features that simplify web development and enhance your applications. See you next video. Bye-bye.